Today's topic for discussion is forms of lichen thallus. Lichen, it is a plant in which two different organisms are associated together, that is algae and fungus together forms a new thallus that is known as lichen. Lichens are very commonly used as spices in India, and there are different forms of lichen thalli described here. First form of the lichen is crustose lichen. The crustose lichens grow in a variety of habitat. Crustose lichens grow rarely in the polluted environment, but mostly the lichens grow in unpolluted environment. And thallus is very closely associated with substratum, which is very difficult to separate. Crustose lichen is like a crust. It is very difficult to separate. The crustose lichens are roughly spherical in outline, and the entire margin of the crustose lichen is not differentiated into lobes. It is more or less circular. The upper surface of the crustose lichen is carbon black in color. Next, the reproductive bodies are in the form of small outgrowths which are randomly scattered on the uppermost surface of the thallus that are called isidia or soridia. There are small uniseriate hair-like structures in crustose lichen which arise from the ventral surface of the thallus that are called rhizines. Rhizines are fully inserted into the substratum and helps in fixation of the thallus. An example of crustose lichen is Graphis. It is a name of lichen. Next, another type of thallus of lichen is folios lichen. Folios means leaf-like, leafy. The folios type of lichens grow close to the substratum, but the margin of the lichen is separable. There are 1 to 2 celled hairy outgrowths arise from the lower surface of the thallus which are called rhizines that helps in fixation of the lichen to the substratum. The rhizines are totally inserted in the substratum which helps to fix the thallus to the substratum. The marginal region of the folios lichen is highly lobed, appear leafy. Hence, the folios lichen resemble the liverworts. Okay, the marginal lobes can easily be separated. The reproductive structures like isidia and soridia are randomly produced from the upper surface of the thallus. The lower surface of the folios lichen is mostly ash colored and the upper surface is carbon black in color. The example of folios lichen is Parmelia. Next, this is the photograph of, there are several crustose lichens and as well as folios lichens are shown in the photograph. This photograph is taken from Ooty, India. And next, fructicose lichen is different from crustose and folios lichen. The fructicose lichens looks like a highly branched hairy herb. It looks like a small herb. The branches are made up of compactly arranged interwoven hyphae along with few of algal elements placed between intercellular spaces. The thalli of fructicose lichen grow erect or in hanging position, mostly on the branches of large trees and older roof and walls. Okay. The hairy outgrowth which is covered the entire thallus is made up of fungal hyphae. Because thallus consists of fungus and algae, if you take the section of any lichen, it consists of only two types of element, that is fungal hyphae and algal elements. Most of the fructicose lichen thalli attached to the substratum by a small disc-like structure. Okay, and the margin of the disc is inserted into the substratum to some extent, and hence that helps to fix the thallus to the substratum, and that can grow in hanging position, that can remain hanged in hanging position. Okay, the fructicose lichens bears a cup like structures which are called fruiting body. These fruiting bodies are mostly developed at the end region of each branch of fructicose lichen, and these fruiting bodies are described as apothecia. Next, this is an example of fructicose lichen. This is Usnea type of lichen. Its name is Usnea, and it is showing fruiting bodies. Next, thank you very much. Save trees, save earth.